Welcome back, everyone. The time is 6:40, negative 6 outside. The 80th Annual Academy Awards are 31 days away.
Now you can watch the event right here on KETV Channel 7. One of the stars of the show, official Oscar biographer Robert Osborne. He'll be greeting the stars on the red carpet, pending, of course, the writer's strike.
Yeah, Robert is the author of 75 Years of the Oscar and an update on the book, 80 Years of the Oscar, scheduled to be published this fall. You can see him as a host on Turner Classic Movies Cable Television Network, which is furnishing us this interview.
Now, Robert joins us this morning live from New York City. Good morning, Robert. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing just great. Thank you.
Well, let me ask you this. Were you surprised by any of the nominations from Tuesday morning?
Well, I was surprised about some. I thought Sweeney Todd might do better in the nomination process. I thought Atonement might get some attention in the Best Actor and Actress categories because that seemed to have a lot of support. There were some surprises also that films like I Am Legend with Will Smith didn't get any even technical nominations. So there are always surprises, but that's what one of the great things about the Academy Awards is you can never directly predict how people are going to vote.
Well, Robert, the writer's strike now in its third month caused the Golden Globes to alter their award show. Are you preparing for the red carpet duties any differently if the stars don't cross the picket
line? No, actually, they're forging right ahead with it, the Academy, with plans for the Academy Awards show very definitely, and the parties afterwards and everything. But what they are doing, they do have a plan B, and that is how to do a show without stars arriving and without the participation in case the writer's strike is still on. So there's a show A and a show B being planned.
Once again, TCM is presenting 31 Days of Oscar, which will showcase previous nominees and winners of the Academy Award.
Yeah, so Rob, go ahead. What are some of your favorite Oscar moments, winning films that will be shown?
In the films we're showing?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you know, the great thing I think about this festival is the fact that, you know, if you really want a background or you want to catch up on the greatest movies ever made, all you have to do is watch our festival. You see Gone with the Wind there. You know, you see musicals with Fred Astaire like Royal Wedding, Oliver, which won Best Picture, Citizen Kane, which didn't, Barbara Streisand, who won for Funny Girl, Julie Christie is up for this year. All these great stars and these great films. So we show them, you know, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, no commercials, no interruptions. And they are just the best movies ever made because every movie we show either won an Academy Award or was nominated for one, including the short subjects that we show in between. So it's a really great way, I think, to not only catch up on your movie history, but also be entertained at the same time.
Robert Osborne, thanks for joining us this morning. Of course,
my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, we want to congratulate you also on your Career Achievement Award. You received that last Tuesday from the National Board of Review.
I did, and it was very exciting because also a lot of the nominees from this year, like George Clooney, Javier Bardem, Julie Christie, were all there. So I got to meet them. That was fun.
All right, you can watch the 80th Annual Academy Awards right here on KETV Channel 7 on Sunday night, February 24th, starting at 7. And for the latest Oscar news, we have special coverage on our website. Of course, that's KETV.com.
You can find a link on entertainment and Hot Clicks pages. Now here's Andrea with First News Weather.